हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ कल्पना चौधरी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, आरबीएनबी कॉलेज, श्रीरामपुर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द कंसेप्ट ऑफ कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज फ्रॉम द टॉपिक सॉल्यूशंस. Now let us see first what is meant by colligative properties. The properties of the solutions which depends on number of solute particles but independent of nature of solute particles. Here, what is colligative properties? The properties of the solutions which depends on number of solute particles, but that is independent on nature of solute particles. Now here, whatever that properties are, that depends upon how many number of ions are involved in the solution of that solute, how many molecules, how many number of moles involved in the solutions, depending upon number of solute particles that properties of that solutions are considered. But that are independent on the nature of the solute particles. That means here, whether that solute particles are urea, whether that one is glucose, whether that one is sucrose, which type of solute particles are used, what is their nature? That means that solute particles, whether that are present in the solid state, whether they are present in the liquid state, depending upon that nature, that properties are not considered. Such type of properties are called as colligative properties. And there are total 4 colligative properties. Let us see first which are that. 4 colligative properties. First property is vapor pressure lowering. Second one is boiling point elevation. Third colligative property is freezing point depression. And fourth colligative property is osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure. Now here, today we have to discuss this first property. What is that? Vapor pressure lowering. Now let us consider here the first property, or that first type of colligative property, that is vapor pressure lowering. Now here we know that any binary solution, which one is binary solution? Binary solution means that solution consists of two contents or two components. Which are that two components? First one is solute. Second one is solvent. Now, in this topic of solutions, we have to consider the solutes of the type non-volatile and solvent, that is volatile in nature. Now, what is this non-volatile means? What? Non-volatile means which do not evaporate. Do not evaporate. and volatile means which undergoes evaporation. Which undergoes evaporation. Binary solution that consists of two components, one is solute, second one is solvent, but solute is of the type non-volatile, and here non-volatile means they do not undergo evaporation, and here solvent that is volatile in nature, so that undergoes evaporation. Now consider here the container, for example here we have considered container, and in this container we have taken the solvent, which one is, this is solvent, this is volatile in nature, this is volatile in nature. For example, consider this solvent, say this as a component, and this container is closed, this container is closed. Now here what happens, as the container is closed, solvent is considered in that container, and that solvent is volatile in nature. Now as the volatility of that solvent is there, that undergoes evaporation, and here vapors are formed. Here vapors are formed, and at surface of the liquid of this A, all particles are A type particles, and here evaporation takes place. Now here whatever pressure is created, that pressure is called as vapor pressure. What is vapor pressure? The pressure exerted due to the vapors created by that solution in that container, that is called as vapor pressure. Now this vapor pressure is of solvent A, that is pure component A, so said this pressure as P naught A, or we can say this as a P naught 1. That is, this vapor pressure is of pure component A, that is pure solvent A. Now here we have to consider binary solution, which consists of solute as well as solvent. Now suppose that solute is generally B component. This is solute. Suppose this is a B component. Now when this solute is added in this pure solvent, then here we'll get formation of solution. This is container. In this container, first we have considered solvent, that is component A, which is pure. Then here we have added that solute particles in this solvent, and the solution is prepared. Then this container is closed. Then here what happens? Here whatever surface area of this solution is there, that is acquired by some B component also along with A component. Here suppose A component, then here surface area is acquired by B component, here B component, B component. Suppose here alternatively that A and B components are present at the surface of the solution. Now, as here A component is volatile in nature and B component is non-volatile in nature, so only A component undergoes evaporation. A component undergoes evaporation, and here B component, as that are non-volatile in nature, does not undergo evaporation in that solution. So here whatever vapors are created, that is of solution, that is of solution, that means of A plus B, that is nothing but solution, and hence said this vapor pressure as P1, said this vapor pressure as P1, because this vapor pressure, although that is due to the component A, but when solute B is added, then solution is prepared, and then here evaporation takes place. Now here if we compare the rate of evaporation in both this container, then here rate of evaporation is maximum, because here only pure solvent is present, and here solvent is not pure because here non-volatile solute is added in this solvent, and obviously as that solute is non-volatile in nature, rate of evaporation is decreased, and here that whatever pressure is there, vapor pressure, that is said to be P1, and that is nothing but the vapor pressure of solution. Now according to Raoult's law, what is that Raoult's law? We have seen that Raoult's law in the last lecture. Here we have seen this Raoult's law. This law relates the number of moles to the vapor pressure of the solution. Now here this law states that partial vapor pressure of any pure volatile component is equal to the vapor pressure of pure component multiplied by its mole fraction. That means here whatever this vapor pressure P1, that is called as partial vapor pressure. This P1 vapor pressure is called as partial vapor pressure because here although that evaporation takes place of only volatile component, but when that B solute is added, then that pressure is exerted. So this pressure P1 is called as partial vapor pressure of component A, and according to this law, this P1 is equal to vapor pressure of pure component. Now here solvent A, that is considered to be pure component, and its pure vapor pressure is P01 into its mole fraction. Suppose that mole fraction of pure solvent is x1. So according to Raoult's law, this equation we have got. But here if we compare both these container, then here as rate of evaporation is higher, that means here P01, that is vapor pressure of pure component, that is solvent, that is higher than partial vapor pressure of solution P1, or we can say that P1 is less than P01. And hence here we can say that when non-volatile solute is added to pure solvent which is volatile in nature, then its vapor pressure is decreased. Why? Because here that surface area of that liquid, that is acquired by that non-volatile particle also, and hence difference between these two pressures P01 minus P1 is nothing but lowering in vapor pressure, that is called as lowering in vapor pressure by the addition of non-volatile solute in the pure solvent. Vapor pressure of solution is decreased, that is called as lowering in vapor pressure. And according to Raoult's law, partial vapor pressure of that component is equal to the vapor pressure of that pure component into its mole fraction. Now we know that one of the concept, that is mole fraction. Concept of mole fraction. Mole fraction. Now what is the mole fraction? It is the ratio of number of moles of any component to the sum of number of moles of all the components present in the solution. Now suppose the solution we have considered, that one is binary solution. That is, two components are present in the solution. Now suppose solvent which is volatile in nature, its mole fractions are x1, and solute which is non-volatile, its mole fractions are x2. Then here, according to mole fraction, what is this x1? X1 is equal to n1 upon n1 plus n2. N1 means number of moles of that solvent divided by sum of number of moles of solvent plus solute. And what is x2? X2 is equal to n2 upon n1 plus n2. Here, number of moles of solute divided by sum of number of moles of both the component present in binary solution. Now, one thing is important, the sum of mole fractions in a solution, that is always unity. For example, we have considered binary solution. Which consists of two components, solute and solvent. Now here x1, these are the mole fraction of solvent, plus x2, these are the mole fraction of solute. Then here we can write x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. And from this equation, we can write x1 is equal to 1 minus x2. Now, if we use this value of mole fraction of solvent in the equation that is got according to Rolle's law, then we can write that partial vapor pressure of component A, that is pure solvent. Here we can write P1 is equal to P01, that is the pure vapor pressure of component A, that is pure solvent, into x1. Now here we can use the value of x1 as 1 minus x2. Then here by solving this bracket, we'll get here P1 is equal to P01 into 1, that is P01, minus P01 into x2, that is P01 into x2. Now here we can rearrange this equation and we can write P01 into x2 is equal to P01 as it is, and this quantity will become negative to that side. Now this P01, that is the vapor pressure of pure component A, that is solvent. And what is this P1? This is the partial vapor pressure of component A when non-volatile solute is added in the solution. That is, this difference is nothing but lowering in vapor pressure. And which is related to mole fraction of solute particles, which is nothing but non-volatile component. And so we can write x2 is equal to, these are the mole fraction of non-volatile solute is equal to P01 minus P1 divided by P01, and this is called as relative lowering of vapor pressure. That means here, although that solute which is non-volatile in nature, its mole fractions are related with the vapor pressure of pure component as well as with the partial vapor pressure of that component in the solution. And we have got that equation as a x2 is equal to P01 minus P1 divided by P01. And hence we can say that, what is that colligative property? Colligative properties of the solutions, these are the properties of the solutions which depends on number of solute particles present in the solution, but that are independent on the type of that solute or that nature of the solute that is present in the solution. Here x2 means mole fraction. That means here we can say that colligative properties that depends upon mole fraction of the solution. That means that can depends upon number of moles of the solute present in the solution. That depends upon number of ions of that solute in the solution. That means that can depends upon number of molecules of that solute present in the solution. But that is independent on nature of the solute. For example, if we consider examples of that solute, for example, if we consider urea, then here that urea that is having its molar mass 60 gram. For example, if we consider glucose, what is the molecular formula? C6H12O6. And its molar mass we can find out by using this formula. If we use sucrose as a solute, its molecular formula is C12H22O11. Now here, if we consider different type of solute particles, then also we'll get the same relation. That means here colligative properties depends upon number of solute particles present in the solution, but that is independent on the nature of the solute particles present in the solution. Although they are having different molecular masses, then also they are related by the same equation. And this is the first colligative property, that is vapor pressure lowering. Thank you.